वेलकम फ्रेंड्स ऑन स्टडी मैक चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एमसीक्यू फॉर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग एंड वी हैव 17 टू 18 क्वेश्चन। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट स्टार्ट। आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिवाइस विच ड्रेन ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम स्टीम पाइप इन जैकेट विदाउट अलाउिंग स्टीम एस्केप थ्रू इट। ऑप्शन इंजेक्टर, स्टीम जनरेटर, स्टीम ट्रैप एंड इकोनोमाइजर। आवर राइट आंसर इज स्टीम ट्रैप। सो लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट स्टीम ट्रैप। स्टीम ट्रैप इज अ डिवाइस यूज टू डिस्चार्ज कंडेंसेट एंड नॉन कंडेंसेट गैसेस विथ नेग्लिजिबल कंजप्शन और लॉस ऑफ लाइव स्टीम। मोस्ट स्टीम ट्रैप आर ऑटोमेटिक वॉल्व, दे ओपन क्लोज और मॉड्यूलेट ऑटोमेटिकली। हियर वी कैन सी फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड स्टीम, इट इज़ अ स्टीम इनलेट एंड राइट साइड स्टीम आउटलेट। हियर वी हैव अ इन्वर्टेड बकेट, सो इन दिस स्पेस द स्टीम विल कंडेंस एंड कन्वर्ट इन टू लिक्विड और वी कैन से वाटर। फोकस ऑन द वर्ड्स, द डिवाइस विच ड्रेन ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम स्टीम पाइप। सो basically this is done by steam trap and air and CO2 vent out from this vent and here it is valve lever to release the surplus steam. Now let's move to the next question. Discharge through V nose is given by, well, very important question. H is to 5/2 for V nose and H is to 3/2 for rectangular nose. Now let's discuss about rectangular nose, V nose, orifice and venturi. Yes, for open channel, if you want to find out discharge, V nose and rectangular nose are used. Discharge through V nose is U is equal to CD 8/15 root twice G 10 θ/2 H^2 5/2 and discharge through rectangular nose 2/3 CD B. Here B is the width of nose, root twice G H^3/2. The basic difference between rectangular nose and V nose and orifice and venturi. Here this one is orifice meter and the above one is venturi meter. Now this venturi meter and orifice meter both are used for pipe flow discharge measurement. For open channel V nose and rectangular nose used. So remember this difference very carefully. Now let's move to the next question. Yes, very important. In a centrifugal casting, impurities are forced toward the outer surface trap near the mean radius of casting, collected at the center of casting, uniformly distributed. Our right answer is collected at the center of casting. Let's see the basic arrangement of centrifugal casting. The yellow portion is our casting, means our product, and the outer periphery it is mold. So mold is supported by top roller and bottom roller, and bottom roller and top roller are driven by means of this motor with the help of shaft. So they support, and by means this support, this mold can rotate on its axis. So here we have axis, and mold rotate clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. So by means of the centrifugal force, we have a centrifugal casting, and impurities collect at center of casting because the density difference between the finished product and the impurity. So due to this density difference, the impurity will collect on the center side and mold on the periphery. So here we have a finished product. Now let's move to the next question. If a diameter of closed coil helical spring, in mechanical engineering normally we have to study closed coil helical spring and leaf spring. Both are very very important. Now let's discuss the question. Helical spring subjected to compressive load is increased from 1 to 2 cm. Here our diameter is increased from 1 cm to 2 cm. Other parameter are same. The deflection will decrease by factor of, so here we have to find deflection because our diameter is increased from 1 cm to 2 cm and other parameter are same. Now as per this equation, 8 pd cube by gd raised to 4, because for the factor if we put the value of diameter over here, then we have 2 raised to q because remaining parameter are same and our final answer is 8. So yes, D is our right answer. Remember that for this coil spring, this one is capital D and the wire diameter, this one is known as small d. So here we are talking about the coil diameter. It is mentioned here, if the diameter of closed coil helical spring, if wire is given then condition is different. Now let's move to the leaf spring. Yes, this leaf spring is used in automobile sector, and this leaf spring are designed to take a torque reaction, driving thrust and side thrust. So these springs are very very efficient, and basically here we have to remember the deflection of leaf spring and the bending stress of leaf spring. So these two equations are very very important, so you can note down this. Now let's move to the next question. Trepanning is performed for finishing drill hole produce large hole without drilling. Yes, our right option is producing large hole without drilling, because the trepanning tool is designed in such a way that it teeth are periphery on the tool and the center portion is hollow. So if this tool is normally hollow and tooth are available on its periphery. Now let's move to the next question. A lead screw with half nuts in a lathe free to rotate in both direction because it has BSW thread, V thread, buttress thread and ACME thread, or we can pronounce it ACME thread. Our right option is D, ACME thread, because power transmission take place in both direction by means of ACME thread. ACME thread also known as trapezoidal thread, and the angle of ACME thread are 29. Here we can see in this diagram, and a British standard width for thread, the angle is 55 degree, and for British association thread BAT, the angle is 47.5. So always remember this difference. Now let's move to the next question. Two plates of same metal having equal thickness are to be butt welded with electric arc welding. When plate thickness change, the welding is achieved by adjusting the current, adjusting the duration of current and changing the electrode size and changing the electron coating. The right answer is changing the electrode size. So always remember whenever equal thickness is given, we have to select this option. Other remaining option are superfluous data to confuse us. Now let's move to the next question. A feet is specified 25H8E8. First of all, we must know what is meaning of 25H8 and E8. 25 means hole and shaft combined size. H means fundamental deviation of hole. 8 means tolerance grade of hole. E means fundamental deviation of shaft. And 8 means tolerance grade of shaft. So H and 8 for hole and E and 8 for shaft. Next is the tolerance value for nominal diameter of 25 mm IT grade 8 is 33 micron and fundamental deviation for shaft is minus 40 micron. Maximum clearance of feet in micron is yes. Here we have to understand one concept, that is this one is our hole and inside the hole this is our shaft. So the upper 33 clearance and lower 33 clearance, 33 plus 33, so 66, and the remaining data are superfluous data, are surplus data. So only our main, we have to focus on hole dimension and shaft dimension. So this is hole dimension minus shaft dimension. Here shaft dimension is minus 40 micron. So hole dimension minus shaft dimension, it is 106 minus minus plus. So option A is our right answer. Now let's move to the next question. It is related to bearing. Life of ball bearing at load 10 kN is 8000 hours. If load is increased 20 kN, keeping all other conditions same, its life in hour will be yes. One thing that we must know, that in our problem it is given that all other conditions are same, and the equation of life of bearing is LH 10^6 by 60 Newton meter. C, that is basic dynamic load, PMFW, it is nothing but PEM related to average axial load, and FW means load factor. Now let's discuss about load factor. Operation with shock loading, load factor is 1.5 to 2.0. Means if we are using, or if we calculate about an automobile bearing. Now normal operation, the range is 1.2 to 1.5. And for gentle operation, the range is 1.0 to 1.2. So for this case, we have to consider that L1 divided by L2 and 1 upon P divided by 1 upon P whole raised to cube for denominator and numerator. Yes, now if we put the value, then we have a final answer. If we calculate this, option B is our right answer. Why? Because if we put the value 10 and 20, so 10 and 20, let me erase all this thing so we have enough space to solve this problem. 1 upon 10, so here it is 1000 because we have a cube, and 20. So here we have 1008. Now 1000 will cancel. Here we have a 8, and L1 by L2, the remaining data is 8000. Here we have to use this 8000 over here, and L2, we have to find L2. So if we solve this equation, L2 is equal to 8000 divided by 8, and our final answer is 8000 divided by 8, that is 1000. Yes, so we have solved this, solve our problem. Option B is the right answer. Now let's move to the next question. In a time study exercise, it is a question from industrial engineering. In a time study exercise, time observed for an activity was 54 seconds. Operator had a performance rating of 120. Whenever performance rating is given, keep in mind we have to divide this value with 100. 120 divided by 100, so we have a value 1.20. Now let's move for next detail. A personal allowance is 10% is given, so that is 0.10. The standard time for an activity is in second, so here we have to find out standard time, and the for standard time equation is normal time. If rating is given, then we have to multiply with rating, multiply 1 plus allowance. Here normal time is given, and that is 54 second. Rating is given, that is 1.20, and multiply with 1 plus allowance, and allowance is 0.10. So our final answer is 71.28. I have already calculated, and it is nearer to 72. So option D is our right answer. Now let's move to the next question. Yes, if 1.5 kilowatt motor is running at 1440 rpm, it is to be connected to stirrer running at 36 rpm. So 1440 rpm convert into 36 rpm. The gearing arrangement suitable for this application is option C, worm gear. So here yes, here our right answer is option C, worm gear. Differential gear, normally differential gear used in automobile, and at the right side this one is helical gear. Here we can see the axis of shaft are parallel, but the teeth are inclined to the axis of shaft, and this one is spur gear, in which axis of shaft are parallel and the teeth are also parallel to axis of shaft. So in this arrangement axial thrust is more, and in case of helical gear axial thrust is low. So always remember the difference of helical gear and spur gear. And this one, it is known as worm gear shaft and worm wheel. So for our case, this is responsible to decrease RPM from 1440 to 36. So our right answer is worm gear. This mechanism is designed in such a way that it can reduce the RPM. Okay, now let's move to the next question. Yes, very important question. When the speed of centrifugal pump is double, here we are increasing RPM, is double, the power required to drive the pump increase 4 times, 8 times, double and remaining same. So always remember these values. Q, discharge, H, head, HP means horsepower. D, related to diameter, N, related to RPM. So remember this Q, H, HP, 3, 2, 5 for D and 1, 2, 3, 4 N. So let's see, or let's solve this problem. When speed of centrifugal pump is double, then power required. So here we have to select this case. If I double the RPM, so for case 1 my RPM is 1, and 4k is 2, RPM is 2 because I doubled my RPM. So 2 raised to 3, so it is 8. So power will increase 8 times. So option B is the right answer. Now let's move to the next question. Chills are used in molds. Reduce freezing time or achieve directional solidification, reduce possibilities and avoid shrinkage. So our right answer is reduce freezing time, achieve directional solidification. Here we have to remember that to achieve directional solidification, chills and padding. Here one more thing I must know that chaplets. Yes, chaplets are used to support core, and core is used to develop a cavity, or cores are used to make a space inside the mold. So always remember the difference between chaplet and chills. So here our right answer is achieve directional solidification. Okay, and the function of chaplet is to make a desired recess inside the mold or to develop the cavity to support the core. Chaplet is normally used to support the core, and chills are used to achieve directional solidification. So our right answer here is option B. Now let's move to the next question. Autocollimator. An autocollimator is used to check option A, runout, B, roughness, flatness and angle. Our right answer is an autocollimator is always used to, before selecting the answer, let's discuss the degree of freedom of an autocollimator. Yes, here we have an autocollimator. So it can move in up direction, down direction. It can also move in backward and forward, and it can also rotate in its own axis, but there is no requirement. And it can move in this direction also, about its vertical axis. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, total 8 degree of freedom. And our right option is option D, the angle. So always remember, autocollimator is used to check an angle. Now let's move to the next question. It is based on power screw. Self-locking in a power screw is better achieved by using multi-start thread, increasing helix angle, decrease helix angle and increase coefficient of friction, decrease coefficient of friction. Now let's discuss about power screw. Here we have a power screw, and if I draw a horizontal plane, so the this inclination or angle between horizontal plane and inclination of the screw or the surface of a thread is known as helix angle. So to lock the power screw for self-locking of power screw, decreasing helix angle and increasing coefficient of friction. This is the right answer. Yes, coefficient of friction take place on the collar friction, mu c. So if I increase the friction and if I decrease this helix angle, then self-locking take place. Yes, so option C is the right answer. Now let's move to the next question. A key, it is based on key. A key connecting to flange coupling to a shaft is likely to fail in direct shear, torsional shear, bending and torsional. Our right option is direct shear. Now let's discuss the axle, shaft, lever, feather key, all key, bearing ball with deep groove, taper, bearing, roller, gear. Okay, gear are designed to take compressive stress in a bending, and tapered roller bearing It is basically designed for radial and axial load. Then bearing ball with deep groove. Well, this type of bearing are normally known as anti-friction bearing, and it is designed to take thrust load as well as radial load. Always remember. And all key are designed to take crushing at shear load, and especially the feather key, it is designed to take turning moment and axial moment. And lever are specially designed for bending moment. Shaft is designed to take bending moment as well as twisting moment, and axle is designed to take a bending moment. So remember this thing. Well, this is the end of video. To be continued, press like button and also give comments. Feedbacks are very, very important. Share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe, and if any suggestion, then you can contact us on studymakeeducation@gmail.com. So thanks for your support, and thank you.